Hey everybody, my name is Chris, and this video is on the Toyota Tundra JLB sound system in my new 2018 Crew Max. One of the biggest complaints on Tundras.com is the high-end system is actually not very high-end, and it's lacking in both sound and volume. On paper, the sound system looks good. It comes with 12 speakers, including a subwoofer and a 440-watt amp. To fix my system, I'm actually going to keep my head unit because I want to keep all the functionality of the head unit. And then after the head unit and actually after the factory amp, I'm going to put in a Rockford Fosgate 360 to signal processor to flatten out the signal coming from the factory amp. And then with the 360, you can actually use it to set your EQ levels and stuff like that. So it's a signal processor and an EQ. In the front doors, I'm going to install some Hertz ESK 165L 300-watt components. And in the rear doors, I'm going to install some Hertz ECX 165 210-watt speakers. And that's all going to be hooked up to an Alpine XA70F amp. And that all is running 170 watts RMS to each of the four channels. I'm gonna replace the sub with two JL Audio 10 TW3 subwoofers, and that's also gonna be hooked up to an Alpine amp. That one's an XA90M, and that's running 900 watt RMS. All right, everything's installed and it sounds good, except for there's a nasty hiss coming from the factory amplifier. With these Tundras, if you want to keep the head unit, you have to keep the factory amplifier. And unfortunately, there is a hiss that comes from that. We tried to tune it out with the 360, but could not get rid of it. Some people say that you can get rid of most of it with a JL fix. And the stereo shop that installed my unit actually was said, hey, do you want to try that? But I just didn't feel like wasting the time because if they say that you only can get rid of most of it, and if I'm going to spend all this money on updating the stereo system, I wanted to keep the head unit, but I also want it to sound good, and a hiss later on down the road, even if it's just a little one, would annoy me to the point where later on I'd go and replace the head unit. So I might as well just do it right now. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to return the 360 because it's no longer needed, and I'm replacing the head unit with a Kenwood DNX 994S Exelon. That is a navigation and stereo system. It's one of the top of the line, actually Kenwood's top of the line until next month when they come out with a new one. So we're going to get that installed tomorrow. And so instead of having two versions of the song, we're going to have three. We're going to have the initial JBL factory system. We're going to have the new stereo with the JBL head unit with the background hiss. And we're going to have the new system with the Kenwood. And just so you can hear what the hiss sounds like, this is with nothing, with no music or anything. We'll just turn on accessory and all right, I had a garbage truck drive by, so let's try this again. That hiss that you hear in the background, the stereo is actually not even on. It's the car is powered up, but the stereo audio is off, and that hiss is the hiss that I'm talking about that's in the background. Once you turn the music up, you really don't hear it, but it shouldn't be there. And it's just something that would annoy me. So we're getting rid of it tomorrow. All right.
Step into a world
that is no one left.
Yeah.